Hello friends, welcome to my channel Vet Visit. Here we are going to study veterinary science for the competitive examination preparation. So friends, today's topic is livestock production techniques. In this we are going to study about milk. This video is prepared by Dr. Hemant and Dr. Dilip Kumar. First topic is Indian milk industry. The current status of dairy in India. India holds a number one position in its annual milk production in all around the world. Total milk production of India is 176.3 million tons. Per capita availability of milk is 375 gram per day. ICMR recommended 280 gram per day. Largest share in the total milk production in India is from Uttar Pradesh, which is about 16.5%, and second largest is from the Rajasthan, which is 12.7%. And the annual growth rate of the milk production is 6.62, which is highest in the Andhra Pradesh. Highest milk producing state of the India is Uttar Pradesh. The state with higher per capita availability of the milk is Punjab, which is about 1220 gram. Highest indigenous milch cow is in Madhya Pradesh. Highest cross and exotic cows are in Tamil Nadu. Highest cattle population is in Madhya Pradesh. Highest buffalo population is in Uttar Pradesh. And highest sheep population is in Andhra Pradesh. And highest goat population is in Rajasthan. So friends, these all points are very much important. Then father of white revolution or milkman of the India is Dr. Verghese Kurien. Oldest dairy farm in India is military dairy farm, which is situated at Allahabad in 1889. Amul. Anand Milk Union Limited, which is situated at the Khera district of Gujarat and formed in the year 1946 as a dairy cooperative movement in India. Operation Flood, which was launched by NDDB, National Dairy Development Board, which was situated in the Gujarat. The Operation Flood first was in 1970 to 1981. Operation Flood second was in 1981 to 1985, and Operation Flood third was in 1985 and 1996. Milk. What is milk? A milk is defined as a whole, fresh, clean lacteal secretion obtained by a complete milking of udder of one or more healthy milch animal, excluding that obtained within 15 days before and 5 days after calving. 15 days before and 5 days after calving. The early secretion of an udder is immediately after parturation is known as colostrum. Milk constitutes mainly in there are two components. First is water and second is total solids. Then there are the total solids are fat and SNFs. Fat are two types, true fat and associated fat. And associated fat includes phospholipids, which is lecithin. Second is cholesterol, it's include carotene, and it's include vitamin, which is A, D, E, K vitamins. Solid not fat includes lactose, which is a main sugar in the milk, nitrogenous substances, which include protein and non-protein substances. In protein substances, it include casein, which is alpha, beta and gamma, lactalbumins and beta-lactoglobulins, and beta-lactoglobulins, alpha-lactalbumins and peptones. And minerals, it also includes minerals and other elements such as pigments, dissolved vitamins and enzymes. The composition of milk. First, water. Water constitutes the medium in which the other milk constituents are either dissolved or suspended. Water is a medium in which other component of the milks are constituted are dissolved or suspended. Milk fat. The bulk of the fat in milk exists in the form of small globules, and which average size is approximately 2 to 5 micron. Note this point, 2 to 5 micron of the average size of the fat globules, which is ranges from 0.1 to 22 microns, and fat exists in the form of oil in water type of emulsion. Note this as an important point, oil in fat is oil in water type of emulsion. Milk fat plays a significant role in the nutritive value, flavor and physiological chemical properties of milk and milk products. Triglycerides or triglycerols is the most common type of fat. Which is the most common type of fat? Triglyceride and triglycerols. Melting point of the fat is about 104 degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit or 40 degree Celsius. Protein. Milk is constituted mainly two proteins. Casein, which is about 80%, and whey. Whey protein, which include 20% in this, it is include beta-lactoglobulins, alpha-lactalbumins. Color of whey is due to riboflavin and it gives a greenish-yellowish pigment. Casein is responsible for the viscosity and white color of the milk. Which protein is responsible for the white color of milk? The answer will be casein. Buffalo milk is white in color due to casein protein, and cow milk is yellow in color due to beta carotenes. Lactose, it is a milk sugar, which is a true solution in the milk. The answer will be lactose. Minor constituents of the milk. First is minerals, vitamins, phospholipids, pigmentations, enzymes, and alkaline phosphatase. Minerals, milk is an excellent source of which calcium. It is about 67% is calcium, and phosphorus and poor sources of iron. Mark this as important, is a poor source of iron, copper and iodine. Vitamins. Milk is a good source of vitamin A, D and thiamine, riboflavin, vitamin B12, poor source of vitamin C. Mark this as important. The milk is poor source of vitamin C. Phospholipids, there are mainly three phospholipids are found, mainly lecithin, which gives a flavor, cephalin and sphingomyelin. Pigmentation. These are the fat globules such as carotene and xanthophylls, and water solubles are riboflavin. Enzymes. First enzyme is alkaline phosphatase. It is a heat sensitive enzyme that the milk that is used for the indicator of the pasteurization. Then phosphatase test is done for the indication of the pasteurization. Legal standards of market in milk in India. So mainly there are the types of milk: standardized milk, recommended milk, recombined milk, toned milk, double toned milk, skim milk, cattle milk and buffalo milk. So they are having a different fat and SNF composition. In standard milk, there is having a fat is about 4.5% and SNF is 8.5%. Recombined milk is having a fat of 3% and SNF is about 8.5%. Toned milk is about having a fat of 3% and SNF is 8.5%. Double toned is having a milk fat of about 1.5% and SNF of about 9%. Skim milk is having fat of about 0.5% and SNF is about 8.7%. Cattle milk is having a fat of about 3.325% and SNF is about 9%, and buffalo milk is having a fat about 5-6% and SNF is about 9%. The chemical composition of milk of different species. Just for example, buffalo, cow, goat, ewe and camels. So the water constituent in buffalo is 84.2%. Cow, it is 86.2% water. In goat, 86.5% water. In ewe, 79.4%. And in camel, that is about 86.5% water is present. In buffalo, the fat is 6.6%. In cow, the fat is 4.6%. Goat is fat is about 4.5%. Ewe fat is about 8.6%. And camel is about 3.1%. SNF of buffalo is 9.86, SNF of cow is about 9.25, SNF of goat is about 7.75, SNF of ewe is about 11.36, and SNF of camel is about 11.9. Protein in the milk of buffalo is about 3.9%, in the cow is about 3.4%, goat is about 3.5%, and ewe is about 6.6%, and camel is about 4%. Lactose of buffalo milk is about 5.5%, cow is about 4.9%, goat is about 4.7% lactose, ewe is having 4.3% lactose, and camel is about having 5.6% lactose. Ash content in the buffalo milk is about 0.8% ash, cow milk is having 0.7% ash, goat is having 0.7% ash, and ewe is having 1.0% ash, and camel is having about 0.8% ash. So friend, please take a screenshot of this page and read it once and twice, and you will remember these all things which are important for the your competitive paper. Energy value. milk fat is having about energy is 9.3 kilocalorie per gram. Milk fat is having energy about 9.3 kilocalorie per gram. Milk protein is having a energy of about 4.1 kilocalorie per gram. Milk sugar is having 4.1 kilocalorie gram per gram, and cattle milk is having about 75 calorie per 100 gram, and buffalo milk is also having 100 calorie per 100 gram. Nutritive value of a milk. The biological value of milk is 90. Milk is low in iron, copper and sodium, and deficient in vitamin C. Physicochemical properties of milk. The pH of milk, which is of a normal fresh sweet milk, usually varies from 6.4 to 6.6 of cow and 6.7 to 6.8 of buffalo milk. Higher pH volume indicates it may be having an udder infection, it may be in the case of mastitis, and lower indicates a bacterial infection. Milk acidity. The fresh milk drawn from the udder possesses a certain acidity, it terms as natural acidity, and which has been distinguished from the developed acidity in the form of lactic acid. Normal acidity or a natural acidity is due to the presence of mainly casein, acid phosphatase, citrate, and lesser extent of the albumin, globulin, and carbon dioxide. It ranges from 0.08 to 0.30%. It is acidity of the milk is 0.08 to 0.30, and colostrum has a higher natural acidity because of its high protein content. Develop on real acidity is due to the lactic acid, and titratable acidity is used as a rapid platform test for the accepting or rejecting of a milk to find out whether the milk is suitable for heat process or not. The titratable acidity of cow milk is varies from average titratable acidity is 0.13 to 0.14% of cow milk, and of buffalo milk is 0.14 to 0.15%. Specific gravity. The average specific gravity of milk is usually ranges expressed as 60 degree Fahrenheit or 15.6 degree Celsius. Addition of water resulting in lower the specific gravity. As we add a water, then the specific gravity will be decreases. And the specific gravity is measured by the instrument known as lactometer, which is mainly uses Zell and Quinnan type of lactometer. The Recknagel phenomena. When the specific gravity of a freshly drawn milk is low and it increases by a 0.01 as a time advances. Matlab, this means that as we draw the milk, it is having a low specific gravity. As the time increases, then its specific gravity is increases by 0.001 times. And this process of increasing of an specific gravity with the time is known as Recknagel phenomena. Why this happen? This is a partial cooling. It is due to partial cooling and solidification of fat, hydration of protein, loss of carbon dioxide, and escape of the air bubbles. The specific gravity of different animals or different type of milk. Cow milk is having a specific gravity of about 1.028 to 1.030, and buffalo milk is having a specific gravity about 1.030 to 1.032. Skim milk is having a specific gravity about 1.035 to 1.037. Water is having a specific gravity of 1. Fat is having a specific gravity of 0.93. And protein is having a specific gravity of 1.346. And protein is having a specific gravity of 1.666. Salt is having a specific gravity of about 4.12. Specific gravity about 4.12. And SNF is having a specific gravity of about 16.16. Note, addition of water and cream. As we add addition of water to the milk or we add a cream to the milk, its specific gravity will going to be decrease. And as we add a skim milk or remove a fat from the milk, its specific gravity will be going to increase. Higher fat, if any milk is having a higher fat, then its specific gravity will be low. And buffalo milk contains more fat than the cow milk, its specific gravity is also high. Freezing point of a milk. The average freezing point of a cow milk is about 0.547 degree Celsius. And buffalo milk is having an freezing point of about 0.549 degree Celsius. Equipment used to determine the freezing point of is Horwath cryoscope. Which instrument is used? Horwath cryoscope. Horwath cryoscope is used to measure the freezing point of any milk. Color of milk is mainly yellow color is due to carotene, and buffalo milk is white in color. Flavor, this is component, smell, odor and taste. Sulfhydryl compound significantly to the cooked flavor of the heated milk. As we heated the milk, then there is having a cooked flavor which is come from the sulfhydryl compounds. Sweet taste to the milk is due to lactose, and salty taste is due to minerals. Sour odor is due to volatile acid. Mark this as important. Sour odor is due to volatile acids. Surface tension of the milk is at 20 degree is about 54.5 dynes per centimeter. Mark this as important. Oxidation reduction potential. The oxidation reduction potential of a milk is usually normally falls within the range of, it is about 0.02 to 0.03 volt. Oxidation potential, reduction potential is 0.02 to 0.03 volt. In the milk, the oxidation reduction potential is of milk is controlled by following substances: dissolved oxygens, ascorbic acid, riboflavin, lactose, cysteine. Milk under anaerobic conditions, oxidation reduction potential will be 0.13 volts. It increases to 0.3 volts on contact with air in the atmosphere, and the bacterial action reduces the oxidation reduction potentials. Methylene blue reduction test, MBRT, is based on the lowering of the oxidation reduction potential through the available oxygen used by the microorganisms. Refractive index. The milk has a refractive index is about, milk is having refractive index is about 1.35. And water is having a refractive index of about 1.33. So as we add a water, then the refractive index will be reduced. Boiling point of water is about 100.15 to 100.17 degree Celsius, which is mainly ranges from 100.2 to 101.02. Emulsion. Emulsion type. Milk is having a fat in water type of emulsion. Mark it as important. Milk is having fat in water type of emulsion. Butter is having water in fat type of emulsion. And meat is having a oil in water type of emulsions. Microbiology of a milk. According to the optimum growth of temperature, bacteria are classified into three groups. There is psychotrophic, mesophilic and thermophilic. Psychotrophic bacteria are grow at the temperature ranges from 5 to 7 degrees Celsius. Mesophilics are from the 20 to 40 degrees Celsius, which is most milk organisms are grow at mesophilic temperature, which is 20 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius, and thermophilic are about grow at the 80 degrees Celsius. Changes in the color of milk. The blue color of milk is due to Pseudomonas cinciani. Red color of milk is due to Bruvibacterium erythrogens and Sarsinia marcescens. And yellow color of milk is due to Pseudomonas syngenta. Brown color of milk is due to Pseudomonas putrefaciens. And green color of milk is due to Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So these all points are very much important. Please friends, take its screenshot. Spoilage type. mainly a soaring in milk, which may be due to lactose is converted into lactic acid. The organism involves are lactobacillus and streptococcus species. The sign of the spoilage is sour milk and curd formations. So this may be due to lactobacillus and streptococcus. Then proteolysis may be in this the organism involves are pseudomonas, bacillus mean various species like bacillus subtilis, bacillus cereus, mycoids, pseudomonas putrefaciens, pseudomonas viscosi, streptococcus, liquefaciens and proteus species. And it indicates if in this milk they are having a proteolysis, then it gives a sign of bitterness. Then bitterness in milk is mainly due to pseudomonas and bacillus liquefaciens and proteus species. Sweet curdling of milk is mainly due to bacillus and proteus and micrococcus species, which give mainly alkaline pH and curd formation. Lipolysis, organism involves are pseudomonas species like pseudomonas fluorescens, acrobacter lipolyticums, yeast examples lipolytica candida, lipolytica and molds includes penicillium species and geotrichum candidum. When there is a lipolysis, then it give a rancid flavor to the milk. Gas production, it may be due to organisms like Clostridium bacteria, yeast, certain yeast example Torula cremoris and Candida pseudotropicalis and Toruplesis spherica. And its sign of spoilage is due to gas production is gassiness. If there is a ropiness in the milk, then it's maybe due to organisms like Alkaligenes, Klebsiella and Enterobacter, which may having a sign of like stringy or slimy milk. Red rot, it is due to the organism like Serratia marcescens, and there is a red coloration of milk in the red rot. In the gray rot is due to the Clostridium species, and which give a gray color and foul smell to the milk. And dairy molds, the organism involves are Aspergillus, Penicillium, Geotrichum, and it gives a moldy appearances. If there is a moldy appearances in the milk, then maybe due to a dairy molds like Aspergillus, Penicillium, and Geotrichum. Bacteriological standards of a raw milk. Standard plate count and grade of milk. If they're having a standard plate count of less than 2 lakh, then it's a very good milk. It's having a 2 to 10, it's having a good milk, 10 to 50, its grade will be fair, and it's having a standard plate count is greater than 50 lakh, then it will be a poor quality of the milk. Note, standard plate count of a pasteurized milk should be exist between a 30,000. Standard milk plate count of the pasteurized milk should be exist between 30,000. Mark this point as important. Freshly drawn milk should be cooled at a 5 degrees Celsius or below and stored at that till it proceed. Preheating of milk should be done at a 35 to 40 degrees Celsius, and cooling and storage temperature of milk is about 5 degrees Celsius. MBRT, its objective is to determine the extent of bacterial contamination. MBRT is done to determine the extent of bacterial contamination of the milk. Its principle as time taken to reduce the methylene blue is a measure its bacterial contamination. If any milk reduces the methylene blue in 5 hours or more, then it is very good milk. It is having a very less bacterial contamination. If it reduces the methylene blue in 3 to 4 hours, it is a very good milk. If it is having reduces the methylene blue in 1 to 2 hours, it is a very fair milk. And if it reduces the methylene blue in 0.5 hours, then it is a very poor milk content. There are various milk platform tests are performed. Mainly first is organoleptic test, which is used organoleptic test is done to determine the color, flavor and taste of the milk. Second is COD, clot on boiling test. It is used to determine the heat stability of the milk. Acidity test is used to determine the final acceptance or rejection of the milk, taking a COB into considerations. Alcohol or ethanol test is used to determine the heat stability of the milk. Alcohol alizarin is to have an idea on the heat stability and pH of the milk. Dye reduction test like MBRT and Rhesusurin is used to determine the extent of bacteriological contamination and growth of the milk. Direct microscopic count is used to determine the type of microorganism present in the milk, and SPC, standard plate count, is used to determine the extent of bacterial contamination in the milk. Lactometer is used to detect the adulteration or the milk in with water, and the coliform count is done to test for the fecal contamination. Fat and SNF tests are used to make a payment of the milk received. Hensa test is, it is the most important test. Hensa test, when there is a mixing of cow and buffalo milk, then we have to differentiate that between a cow and buffalo milk, then the Hensa test is performed. Phosphatase test is used adequacy of pasteurization. Mark it as for adequacy of pasteurization, which test is done, then will be the phosphatase test. Mark it as phosphatase test will be done for the adequacy of the pasteurization. Dalwalkie test is the presence of antibiotic and sulfur residue in the milk. And bromocresol purple solution is a detergent in the milk. Bromocresol purple solution is done to detect the detergent in the milk, and picric acid solution test is used to detect the xylitin in the milk, and dimethyl amino benzaldehyde reagent is used to detect a urea in the milk. CMT California mastitis test, strip cup test, CAMT test are used to detect a diagnosis of the mastitis, and picric acid test is used to detect a xylitin in the milk. So thank you friends, I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel, share this video with your friends and like this video. Thank you friends.